Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover UPSC JWM 2010 paper. This is part 2. Question is, a furnace wall has a thickness of 50 cm and thermal conductivity of 0.7 watt per meter Kelvin. What will be the required thickness of a new material having thermal conductivity equal to 0.14 watt per meter Kelvin if the heat loss and temperature drop across the wall are the same as before? So initial case, wall thickness is 50 cm, thermal conductivity K1 is 0.7 watt per meter Kelvin, temperature drop is delta T1, heat loss is Q1. And second case, thickness of the new material we have to calculate, unit also same, centimeter. Thermal conductivity K2 is 0.14 watt meter Kelvin, delta T2, temperature drop and heat loss. So both are same, delta T1 equal to delta T2 and Q1 equal to Q2 given in the question. We have to calculate L2. So formula we will use, Q equal to Ka del T divided by L or del X, whatever we can. So here Q1 equal to Q2. Put the value of Q1, K1 A1 delta T1 divided by L1 equal to K2 A2 delta T2 divided by L2. So A1 same, delta T1 also same. Finally K1 by L1 equal to K2 by L2. Sorry, here L2. L2 is K2 by K1 into L1. K2 is 0.7. Sorry, K2 is 0.14 divided by 0.7 into L1 is 50. So if you solve this one, finally we will get 10 centimeter. This is our answer. B is our answer. Two-dimensional state of stress at a point sigma x equal to 100 newton per mm square, sigma y equal to 20 newton per mm square and tau xy also not given, only tau xy. If the larger principal stress at the point is 110 newton per mm square, the smaller principal stress will be how much? So data given are sigma x equal to 20 newton per mm square. All are positive. Larger principal stress, sigma 1 is 110 newton per mm square. Smaller principal stress, sigma 2, we have to calculate. Minimum value of the normal stress. And sigma 1 is maximum value of the normal stress. So Mohr's circle we will use. Tau axis and this is sigma axis and tau axis. Change the color. Sigma x take here. It's 100 newton per mm square. Sigma y is 20 newton per mm square. Take the midpoint between 100 and 20. So total is 100 minus 20 is 80. Midpoint should be 20 plus 40, 80 by 2. It will come at 60. 60 plus 40 equal to 100. So midpoint is 60. This to this distance is 40. So then sigma 1 given. Sigma 1 here It's 110, and we know from center we got, and radius also we got 110 minus 60, it's 50. So this distance is our radius. We can draw the Mohr circle. If we will draw the Mohr circle, we will get here this point is sigma, and this point is sigma 2. Sigma 2 equal to 60 minus 50, it's 10 Newton per mm square. This point is sigma 2 point. So it's 10 Newton per mm square. A is our answer. If in this question they will ask for maximum shear stress, sometimes they may ask, this is maximum value of shear stress. This is radius of Mohr circle, it's 110 minus 60. You will get 50 Newton per mm square. This is maximum value of Mohr circle or radius of the maximum value of the shear stress or radius of the Mohr circle. It's 50 Newton per mm square. Question is matching least one with least two. So, least one double helical gears connecting parallel shaft and B two non-parallel or intersecting but coplanar shaft, C two non-intersecting and non-parallel shaft connected by gears, D gear of shaft meshing externally with a straight to thread member, least two one rack and pinion, two spiral gears, three bevel gears, four herringbone gear. So, double helical gears, we know it's a herringbone gear. This question was also asked in GATE examination, so this is very important. Double helical gears connecting parallel shaft, it's herringbone gears. A is 4, so you can omit C and A. Then B, two non-parallel or intersecting but coplanar shaft. They are not parallel or intersecting. Coplanar shaft, then two non-intersecting and non-parallel connected by gears, non-parallel and non-intersecting, this is C should be 2, so from here D is our answer. D we can check, gears of shaft meshing externally with a straight two-thirds member, D is 1, rack and pinion. So D is our answer. A with 4 and B with 3, C with 2, then D with 1. Then again matching question, least one with least two. A degree, least one degree of reaction, B net head, C flow ratio, D hydraulic efficiency, least two one power given by water to runner to inverse of root over of capital H, where H is the head on turbine, 3 change of total energy inside the runner, 4 friction between water and penstock. So degree of reaction, A is change of total energy inside the runner, A is 3, so B and D not possible, B and D we can cancel. Then net head leave it, flow ratio is Bf2 by Bf1. Bf1 is root over of 2gh, so C will match with 2, so from option C is our answer. So others also we can check, hydraulic efficiency, D is 1 here, hydraulic efficiency, power given by water to runner, and B net head, B is 4, net head is friction between water and penstock. Yes, this is correct. So, C is our answer. Consider the following properties of engineering materials. 1. Density, 2. Conductivity, 3. Elasticity, 4. Hardness, 5. Ductility. This is also asked in IES examination. Same question. So, properties of engineering materials, mechanical properties, we have to find out. So mechanical properties, here elasticity is mechanical properties, and hardness also mechanical properties, 5 ductility also mechanical properties, 3, 4, 5. So C is our answer. A 50 kg box rests on a horizontal floor for which coefficient of friction is 0.3. If the box is subjected to a horizontal towering force of 400 Newton, what is its velocity after 5 seconds from rest? Take g equal to 10 meter per second square. So its velocity after 5 seconds we have to calculate. So let this is the box, it's at rest on the horizontal floor, mg downward, normal reaction n, 400 Newton force, frictional force, it's mu into n, velocity we have to calculate, this is force g is 10 meter per second square, so mg 50 into 10, 500 Newton. Frictional force n is n equal to mg, it's 500 Newton. Frictional force mu is 0.3 into n is 500. So 0.3, 3 by 10 into 150 Newton. This is frictional force. Velocity we have to calculate. So F is 400 minus 150, it's 250 Newton. So Newton second law, F equal to ma. F is net force, it's 250 equal to 50 into acceleration, so A is 5 meter per second square. Acceleration we got. So B equal to u plus a t, we will use here from rest, so u equal to 0. B equal to a is 5 into time is 5, so it's 25 meter per second. Answer is D. This is also so many times asked in IAS and other exams, so this is very very important. Match least one with least two. List one X chart, B R chart, C P chart, D C chart. List two, 1 precision, 2 number of defect, 3 fractional defect, 4 accuracy. So X and R chart, P and C chart, both are different. P and C chart, P chart is fractional defect, so C should be with 3, C with 3, A and B you can cancel, and C chart, D is C chart is number of defects, C should be with 2, wait, C is P chart is 3, C should be with 3, and C chart in D should be number of defect, D should be 2. So D is our answer. A is 4, X chart is accuracy, R chart is precision. This is also correct. This is very very important. Question is, a cantilever beam of square section 100 mm into 100 mm and length 2 meter carries a concentrated load of 5 kN at its free end. What is the maximum normal bending state at its mid-length cross section? So this is a cantilever beam of square cross section, concentrated load at its free end, let this is the load P equal to 5 kN. Length is 2 meter, cross section area also given. It's 100 mm into 100 mm, 100 into 100. What is the maximum normal bending stress at its mid length? Mid length means at 1 mm from any end. This is 1 meter. Here at this point is 1 1. This section is 1 1. At 1 1, we have to calculate the maximum bending stress. Bending formula is sigma b by y maximum sigma b by I equal to sigma b or bending stress sigma b by y maximum equal to I is moment of inertia, it's m by I. M is moment, then I is moment of inertia. So sigma b equal to m by I into y maximum. Y maximum is distance from neutral axis. So first moment we have to calculate. This point at 1 1, moment is p into distance. M is p into distance is 1 meter. So 5 into 10 to power 3 into 1, this is moment. This is in Newton meter. I is 8 to the power 4. This is in Newton meter. So options are in Newton per mm. So again multiply 10 to power 3. 10 to power 3 into 10 to power 3. Newton into mm. 8 to the power 4 divided by 12. 100 to the power 4 divided by 12. So you will get 100. 10 to the power 8, 10 to the power 8 you will get 10 to the power 8 by 12. And y max is 100 by 2, 100 by 2. So just put the values. So from here 10 to the power 6, 100, 10 to the power 8 cancel, 2, 30 newton per mm square. So from option C is our answer. This type of question also they are asking in ISRO and IES. So this is very, very important. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.